Welcome to The Explainer. Today, we're breaking down an absolutely brilliant invention that takes one of the oldest structures known to man, the simple well, and completely revolutionizes it to solve a very modern problem. It's a fascinating story, so let's jump right in. So, let's start with a puzzle. Picture India's Konkan region. This place gets an incredible amount of rain during the monsoon season. We're talking up to 4,000 millimeters. But just a few months later, the wells run dry and they face a serious water shortage. So the question is, how on earth is that possible?
Well, it all comes down to the local geology. First, the soil there is something called lateritic soil, which is super porous. You can think of it like a giant sieve. The rainwater just pours right through it. Then you have the hilly terrain, which acts like a massive waterslide, sending all that runoff rushing straight to the sea. And any water that does manage to seep down goes so deep, so fast, that it's nearly impossible to get to. The result? All that amazing rain is lost, and the wells go high and dry.
But what if you didn't have to just accept that? What if you could actually capture that massive downpour before it all disappears? Well, a team of engineers decided to tackle this problem by completely rethinking the most fundamental water structure they had, the humble open well.
The solution they came up with is officially called the Multilevel Water Storage Arrangement, and it was developed by a team including retired engineering professor Dr. Shekhar Gadgil, Rohini Gangal, and structural engineer Mr. Ravindra Nene. Now, I know it's a technical-sounding name, but the concept behind it is just ingenious.
And you know, this isn't just some pie-in-the-sky idea, because it's a fully patented invention, officially recognized by the government of India for being a truly novel solution.
Okay, so let's get into the nitty-gritty. This is a drawing from the actual patent, and it shows the core of the idea. It's a brilliant layered system that basically creates multiple separate water tanks stacked right on top of each other, all inside a single well. Let's break down exactly how they do it.
The entire system has five main parts, and to really understand it, we're going to build it from the very bottom all the way to the top.
All right, so at the very base, you have the first reservoir. Now, this part is totally natural. It's the original bottom of the well that taps into those deep, clean groundwater springs that seep in through the rock year-round. A submersible pump sits down here, ready to lift that water up when it's needed.
Now, here's where the real engineering magic kicks in. You've got this pure groundwater at the bottom. How do you store hundreds of thousands of liters of rainwater on top of it without the two mixing? Simple. You build a floor, right inside the middle of the well.
This is the partition, and it is the absolute heart of this invention. You can see from the diagram, it's not just a simple concrete slab. It's a seriously reinforced platform with a grid of beams, and it's built right at the point where the soft soil layer meets the hard rock. This is the crucial barrier that separates the clean groundwater below from all the rainwater they're going to store above it.
And this thing has to be incredibly strong. I mean, it is the backbone of the whole system. Think about it. It has to support the massive weight of all the water pushing down from above and fight the pressure of the groundwater pushing up from below.
That upward force is called hydrostatic pressure. You know that feeling when you dive to the bottom of a deep pool and your ears start to hurt? That's hydrostatic pressure. Well, this partition has to withstand that same kind of force, but on a massive scale, from both directions. It's a serious structural engineering challenge.
So, once that super strong partition is in place, you've basically created a new floor. And on top of that floor, you build the second reservoir. This is the main rainwater collection tank. It captures all that surface runoff that used to get washed away. It can even be used to store water that's been pumped up from the reservoir below, creating a kind of water bank.
But wait, I hear you asking. If you've sealed off the bottom, how do you ever get to that pump for maintenance? Ah, that's where this clever multifunction duct comes in. It's a sealed tube that runs all the way down, giving access for repairs. But it also does two other really important things. It makes sure no contaminated surface water can leak into the pure groundwater, and it helps relieve pressure on the structure. Just a brilliant piece of design.
And if that wasn't enough, they add one more layer of storage. At ground level, they build what's called an annular tank. You can see it here. It's basically a giant concrete donut that wraps around the top of the well, creating a third, super accessible reservoir.
So, you have to admit, it's an amazing design on paper. But the real test, the only thing that really matters is, does it actually work in the real world? Let's take a look.
Total additional water that a single retrofitted well can hold is a truly staggering 300,000 liters.
And here's how that breaks down.
That second reservoir, the one they built inside the well, holds about 200,000 liters. And then that annular tank, the concrete ring on the surface, adds another 100,000 liters of storage.
For a place like Konkan, this is an absolute game changer. All that stored water means farmers can grow crops year-round, not just during one season. It means there's reliable drinking water long after the monsoons have ended. And best of all, it achieves this by sustainably upgrading the infrastructure that's already there. It's a powerful solution to that water paradox.
So, let's just put it side by side. On the one hand, you have a traditional well that dries up every year. It's vulnerable, and it has very limited capacity. On the other, with this invention, you get a year-round water bank that stores both groundwater and rainwater, protects the purity of the water, and adds a massive amount of new storage. It turns a seasonal liability into a permanent asset.
Which brings us to a final, really big question. This amazing invention was created to solve a very specific problem in one region of India. But you have to wonder, could the principles behind it, separating water sources, using vertical space for storage, and upgrading old infrastructure, be a blueprint for other places around the world that face that same frustrating paradox of having way too much water and then suddenly not enough? It's a powerful idea to think about.